Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He took his booty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking big hit. I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only.
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. Set for a start as we are underway from MetLife Stadium. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. They'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. From the gun, here's Stafford. He's got his target, it's the tight end Tyler Higbee. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. Stafford on 1st down. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Touchdown, LA! Like so many wide receivers, he is a threat with the ball in his hands, and he's able to do his damage here after the catch.
And that should serve as a big warning to this defense. They know now that they have to stick close to these receivers because they have the ability to break games wide open after the catch. And that one wound up in the end zone.
And the next-gen stats show us the tale of how much yardage he was able to tack on after the catch. Matt Gay on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Rams 7, Giants nothing.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Returning it, John Ross. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 18. Off play action, Jones. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. They could not ask for a worse start. You give up a touchdown on the game's opening drive, and then you turn right around and throw the interception on your very first play.
And this is where the coaching staff has to earn its money, because they've got to calm these guys down a little bit. Just as you noted, a horrendous start both sides of the ball. But now the defense, which gave up an opening drive touchdown, they've got to go out there now and start playing like the team they want to be.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. Off of play action, here's Stafford. He's got the first down here inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive, and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Absolutely nowhere to go with the football, and he's just going to put this one in the Hudson River. Maybe he's a little fortunate he didn't get called for grounding, because that one was well over everyone's head.
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw, it's complete into the hands of Higbee. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense, humming here in the early going.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, Stafford. And it's caught. Touchdown, Rams. Matthew Stafford finding Cooper Kupp for the touchdown there. And the Rams have... Taking a 13-0 first quarter lead. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. Now you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Throwing on first down, Jones. This one goes out wide for Barkley. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jones, he dumps it off to Barkley. Barkley a first down and more. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. He was brought down by Troy Reader.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From the gun, Jones, flush to his right. And Jones will hit the deck here, and he is able to pick up the first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Looking to throw, Jones. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. Not much there, only a yard.
A gain of a yard brings up second and 9 at the Rams.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. To throw again on second down. Jones eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Back to throw. Jones. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Facing this big first half deficit, they keep the field goal unit on the sideline. They're going for it. Now Jones throwing on fourth down. He'll get this one to Galladay. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Jones throw here, taken in by Ingram. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They'll look to throw again. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Touchdown, Giants! Saquon Barkley, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Giants have got it back to a one-score game. Extra point try, good by Gano. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. The touchdown here to kick it away. Powell now to take it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
Well, I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Here's Stafford. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that's caught inside the 30.
Another day, another
touchdown,
dollar,
LA. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and it's now 21-7. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play there for the Giants. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. looking to throw. Jones flushed out right. That's caught by Galladay. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. A give to Barkley out of the gun. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. From the 2 now, second and goal. Barkley again. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Giants able to get this back within a touchdown. Gano the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Howell now to take it out of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Here's Stafford. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Jalen Smith, the Notre Dame man, in on the tackle. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. A shotgun snap for Stafford. He's going to look for Beckham in the end zone. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. And oh, that one going to wind up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. 3rd down coming up. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Steps away to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Bernardrick McKinney there to make the stop.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving.
Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked up by James Bradbury. The 40. 20. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. So they had a good drive going, a chance to build on this first half lead, but now you kind of feel like we got a new ball game.
And you wonder what the discussion will be now at halftime, because I think we were headed towards 1. Now it's a different discussion altogether. One side optimistically, the other side wondering what could have been.
Couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. This taken in at the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they've got just under 50 seconds, so time enough to try to work their way downfield if they so choose. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now a play fake it at Stafford. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And this one is incomplete.
Two things you can do in that situation: run and punt the football or try and take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but they'll have to punt all the same.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Oh, and that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions. And here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield. He was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Jones from the gun on third down. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. Back to throw again. Dancing to his left. That's complete to John Ross. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. 4 seconds left, and there's the timeout. In field goal range and a chance to tack on three before intermission. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. Gano's kick is good, and with it, they'll take the lead at 24-21. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime, but the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Thank you.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
From the 27, Jones. Right back to Tony. He's got another one. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he will be knocked down hard, but he will have the first down.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs. That big guy, oh, he's a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
And now Joe Judge going to turn to an official and signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Play fake, Jones, and this one hauled in by Rudolph. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. On second down, here's Barkley. And he's got some space here. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York.
Well, we've had some great running backs in the NFL the last decade or so. Saquon Barkley might be among the smoothest of them all. What a heck of a run right there.
Extra point try, good by Gadeau. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Gadeau now following the touchdown here to kick it away. On the return is Brandon Powell. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Out of the gun, Stafford. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Xavier McKinney. And the Giants are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. So the deep ball giveth, and now the deep ball taketh away.
And you get deep on me here. I like that. Going to the next level in what you're thinking. And when you think about all the success he's had throwing the football so far, sometimes when you're doing that, you think you're invincible out there. But he was given a cold dose of reality on that throw.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. He'll buy some time right. Looking for his tight end, Rudolph, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. This one to the left to Higbee. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. They'll run on first down. Akers stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. From the 27, Stafford. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Stafford. That's out to the flat for Akers. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. So the completion good for just three. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. That's to his running back complete. And I think the ball's out. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And hindsight 2020, I think they probably should have gone for the field goal, right?
The 3 points would look really good right now, but I think what we just saw there, analytics really starting to creep into the game because more and more teams are saying the more you go for it, the better your odds of getting it, the better your odds of scoring 6 points instead of three. They took a chance there. It just didn't pay off.
Yeah, right here, the anti-analytics guys go thumbs up. Sliding out of the pocket. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Second and six.
Shotgun, they run with Barkley. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Now Jones. Man open, it's Tony. He's got it. And he will have a Giants first down. They needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting eight.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots,
and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Jones just going to bat this forward on the jet sweep. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Three quarters have come and gone. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Throwing Jones. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. It was Von Miller who shot in there to get him down.
Well, here's where having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him and took him down for a big loss, partner.
A really big loss. Another try after the first down sack. Jones, open man right side is Ingram. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion, they would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Here's Jones to throw on third down. Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Von Miller able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Throwing a Stafford. Open man is Higbee, the tight end. And he's brought down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And he's taken down inside the 30. But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
On first down, Akers. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Stafford now to throw. That's caught left side. It's Higbee, the tight end. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. On the handoff, it's Akers. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. on second and nine. Stafford. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Julian Love picks it.